In Bereshit Perek Dalad, we have the genealogical tables of the generations between Adam and Noach. In Pasuk 20, we are told that Adah gave birth to Yuval, and Yuval's claim to fame was that Hu Haya Avi Yoshev Ohel Umikneh. Rashi defines the term Avi as Hu Haya HaRishon. He was the first to bring to the world a fundamental change, and that change was reflected in the fact that he was, as opposed to previous generations, a Yoshev Ohel Umikneh. Rashi defined as a person who was a shepherd, a herdsman of the Behemot HaMidbarot, of the animals that roamed the wilderness. The Torah time frame may differ quite substantially from the archaeological timeline, but in this respect, Pasuk 20 can be aligned with the record of society's evolution. Man had moved from the hunter-gatherer to a life of greater stability, which involved farming the land and the grazing of herds. This was a major change in that it led to the formation of villages and hence the beginnings of society and its infrastructure. Yuval is described as a Yoshev Ohel, as opposed to a Bayit. The difference between the two terms is that Bayit implies a degree of permanence, whereas the Ohel would suggest temporary living conditions and movement from place to place. This ties in quite nicely with the concept of the shepherd and the herdsman, reflected in the Rashi, V'Yoshev Ohalim Chodesh Kan V'Chodesh Kan. He could not live in a house. At best, it was a tent, because he would remain 1 month here, then move on elsewhere for another month, Bishvil Mir'etzono, to feed the flocks, Ukashakala HaMir'eh B'Mokom Zer, when the food supply for the animals was no longer available in one location, Holech V'Tokeya Oholo B'Mokom Acher. He then moved elsewhere, to other parts of the land, and reassembled his ohel, his tent. Rashi then goes on to provide a Medrash Agada interpretation to the term Yoshev Ohel Umikneh. And therefore, as we see, the first time that the text uses the word Mikneh, Rashi feels the need to define this term. And once Rashi has linked the term Mikneh to Behema, that link remains valid for the rest of Sefer Bereshit. It is for this reason that in all subsequent times in which the word Mikneh is used by the text, Rashi makes no commentary as to its definition. As such, one cannot argue that in Bereshit 36 there might have been a need for Rashi to define the term Mikneh. This, in effect, brings us back to question 3 of the set of 4, regarding the fact that Rashi, in his commentary to 36.7, disregards the term used by the Chumash Mikneh in favor of Behema, which at this point in time seems to have been an unnecessary change.